So let's practice with CBMEM. First step we can skip because we already did that. In second step we will look at the Debian image partition layout to be able to calculate the offset of the loopback device, where the loopback device will begin inside our image. In that way we can, despite the our image contain multiple partitions, we can just mount one of the partitions. We create some directory, then we mount the loop device into loop directory, and we can copy inside the image the compiled CBMEM binary. We just unmount and detach all the loopback devices. Then we can boot and actually see how CBMEM works by gathering logs and like how we can extract those logs from the memory. So let's try to use those instructions. First of all, let's use our Docker container. Then we can simply check partition table. You can see that our first partition, which is our system, starts at the block 2048, and size of the side of the sector is 512 bytes. So just to calculate this, 512 gives us this number. Of course, we will use that number to create loopback device. And then we can create loop directory. It's already exists. Let's check if nothing's inside. Let's mount the dev loop 0 in loop directory. Yeah, so I have typo here. Okay, in loop we have all the information of all the root file system of our Debian. Let's copy the CBMEM binary. You can check that it's there. We can see here. So let's mount a loop. Let's detach all the devices, and now we can use our old alias to boot the system and run CBMEM. And our disk that we just modified. In the same way, you can use a method for transferring out the files. So you can see we have CBMEM here. So we can create some files inside this system and then mount the Debian image and extract those either dumps, either some logs. Or of course you can use networking for that. So let's check minus C, and you can see that we already, so minus C so minus C means that it will show us console. It's console log which was gathered during the boot time. Of course we unless we have buffer in the memory, and this buffer is controlled on the build time of the core boot. We may have multiple boot, so that's why we have this minus one option, which gives us just last boot. And there is coverage information, maybe let's no coverage information included. there is list of tables which are included. There is quite a lot of them, so all this table can be presented. There are some TPM logs if they were gathered. There are some timestamps. Unfortunately, in case of QMO, we will have problem of calculating time because there is not enough correct CPU frequency information in the system. But we can use console and look what's going on here. And as you can see, we see boot block starting, like in the classical boot log from coreboot. Then there is ROM stage, and it continues booting with all the stages. And that's it.